also do a little bit of a time lapse and a little bit of showing the auto fair and meeting Chip Foose. Start off with the auto fair is in Charlotte, North Carolina, at the Charlotte Motor Speedway. And this year they were supposed to be having Chip Foose, which if many of y'all do not know, or you may know, he is a automotive car designer from Southern California. And what happened was, is what really got him started, he used to work for Boyd Coddington, which, you know, he's done long gone now, but he ended up creating this car that was called the Hemisphere. And what happened was, is Plymouth decided to make what they called the Plymouth Prowler, after he designed the Hemisphere, and that's what it looks like. So he pretty much designed that car for Plymouth, and then he's done, you know, numerous amounts of cars since then, some trucks as well. He has a truck that I really am fascinated with, and it, I actually have a diecast model of it. I'm gonna see about getting it signed if I can, but what it was, it's a 1956 Ford F-100, and if I'm not mistaken, it was his dad's truck that got handed down to him, and then he ended up on the show overhauling his team. Instead of him being in there with his team and getting it all designed up and everything, and creating vehicles for other people, fixing up vehicles for other people, his A-team and AJ and Chris and them, they ended up taking his truck and fixing it for him. So it kind of goes with me a little bit there, as far as like my dad's truck. Hopefully one day my dad will decide to hand me the keys to his truck, which it is a Northern made truck. It was made in Canada. It's a Ford, but it was made in Canada, so it has seen a lot of the it's got a lot of the rust problems that most vehicles from up in that area have, so it does need a lot of work done to it, but it's just, I guess, kind of like a bond there. So if I were to get it, and we've talked about it, but I would kind of take it and just rebuild it from the ground up, restore it and everything, and throw a few little extra goodies on there, just kind of, you know, make it look a little bit cooler than factory. But you know, because that's what my channel's all about, or started out as, trucks that had some modifications done to them. But so I'm gonna see if, you know, whenever my dad does decide to hand me the keys over, I'm gonna, you know, just start building that thing up, and that's kind of how it was for Chip Foose. You know, his team built that truck for him, and so if y'all have ever seen, he had started a show called Overhauling, and what he did on there, like I said, he had what he called the A-team. He had his co-host AJ and Chris. They were on there, and they pretty much went and got people's cars that, you know, somebody who had just been through so much and didn't have no money to fix up their vehicle, they went and got it, and they took it to the shop, and they made it, made the people think that the car got stolen and all that, and they fixed it up, and then they bring the people back in there, and they show them, and, you know, it was just a really great show, you know. I ain't seen it in a while. I don't even think it's on anymore. I ain't really had time to check, but I used to watch it all the time growing up. And so Chip Foose is kind of like a he was kind of like a mentor, you know, not somebody that you could talk to face to face or every day, but it's kind of that person who I looked up to some, you know, one of the people I looked up to growing up, because I just kind of wanted to be like him a little bit, following his footsteps with drawing. I mean, he draws some amazing designs for cars and stuff, and you know, that's kind of where I got my drawing, and maybe one day y'all see, you know, some of the stuff I drew in the past, which I don't draw as much now as I used to. Well, I hardly ever draw now, but used to I would draw a lot of trucks and everything. So, you know, I kind of got that after watching him do it, and you know, mine ain't nowhere near as good as his are, but you know, they're decent enough for me to be satisfied with them. And so, you know, it's just somebody who's kind of been a lifelong one of my idols. So to be able to meet him in person and to get an autograph right there in person from him is going to be pretty amazing. So what I'm going to do is, like I said, I'm going to kind of vlog a little bit here and let y'all know about it. And then I'm going to get some time lapse of driving to Charlotte. It's pretty good. It's a little bit, you know, ways from here, where I'm at right now. But I'm going to get a little bit of time lapse of driving down there. And whenever I get there, I'll show you the speedway. Kind of show you Z-Max also, because Z-Max is pretty much right there down the road from it. So they got Z-Max, they got a dirt track, and then they got Charlotte Motor Speedway. If y'all ever look at it, like on I guess Google Maps or whatever, if y'all do like a overlook view of it. And I've been to Z-Max, you know, a couple times before, so I'm very familiar with the area. I've never been into the Charlotte Motor Speedway though, so this will be my first time going into there. So y'all might have to bear with me a little bit as I find my way around. But today seems like it's the weather's just kind of doing its own thing. It's rainy and then it stops. And I mean, it's been windy all freaking day. But it's kind of cool, but it's kind of warm at the same time. Like whenever the wind's blowing and it kind of cools off a little bit, and then it rains, and then all of a sudden it gets warm again, I guess because of the humidity and everything too. So, you know, as a matter of fact, it's getting ready to start raining again right now. But it was 50, I think 56 a minute ago, and now my temperature's showing 62. So, I mean, it's crazy. The sun, it'll come out for a couple minutes and be just as bright as it can be, and then go back in behind the clouds and we'll get some more rain. So hopefully we won't get rained out while we're down there. I mean, you know, I don't know how it's been down there so far, but I'm heading that way. Well, I gotta make a stop. I gotta make a few stops real quick, and then I'm gonna head down that way, you know, get some time lapse video, get a little bit of video while I'm down there, and then I'll head back and vlog a little bit on my way back and tell you about how everything went. And so y'all just stay tuned, and I hope y'all enjoy it. I'll see you soon. Alright, YouTube. We almost there. We on the exit now. All I gotta do is turn left and then about maybe a mile we'll be coming up on Z-Max and Charlotte Motor Speedway. So y'all get to see what it looks like. Also, it is freaking windy. I'm gonna tell you right now, driving on the highway, as fast as the wind gust is, I mean, it was hard keeping the truck on the road. I can only imagine the 18-wheelers and stuff, you know. I know they have a time, that wind pushing up against them. But maybe y'all noticed in that time lapse of that state trooper come flying by. I was actually doing like 75, 80 mile an hour when he come whizzing by me. And I'm telling you, that was crazy. I didn't know who he was going after until I seen it. So, but now we just keep going straight. We'll be there in about a minute, depending on how traffic is. tags over there just to blow. Parking spot. I may have to pay $5, but that'd be all right. Be worth it. We'll see y'all inside. Going on YouTube. I'm back now. I've left the speedway now. Just trying to get back up the highway. Traffic sucks right now. I was literally probably crawling at 5 mile an hour a minute ago, and looks like we're about to slow down again. But if I could show you the other side of the highway, I can't right at the moment, but man, we want to talk about crazy. It's 5:30 traffic. I came at a bad time, but at the same time, you know, I got to meet Chip Foose. I got the autograph. That's like the most coolest thing in the world to me. That's one of my idols growing up, so I was real happy about that. I actually got two autographs. How did I do that? Well, they've given posters out of his new creation he built a little while back. It was called The Imposter. he was signing autographs for that. So I got one of them. And well, we're slowing down here. I was gonna show y'all. Wow, we are literally about stopped. I'm doing 10 mile an hour on a highway. Anyway, so back to the story. I'll tell y'all a little bit, and then, you know what? Actually, I'll show y'all the stuff. Right here, that's the imposter. That's his autograph, and it says my name, too. It says, good luck. And also, I told y'all about that truck that I was trying to get signed. I was able to do it. I was able to get Chip Foose's signature on that truck, so... That was awesome. That meant the world to me, you know. So I'm gonna have a good weekend this weekend. I know that. I'll tell you this though. I did hate it for him, having to stand out there in the cold. You know, they should have had him inside or something. I don't know. Maybe I can call and mention that to him. But it might be too late now. I don't know. Anyway, he was outside signing autographs out, and I mean, it's windy like crazy. I couldn't get a whole lot of video while I was in there, just because the line, I just had to, the time frame I had to hurry up and get to the line. And then I just kind of had to wait in line there, and finally did get to meet him though. But he told me, and this is something else kind of cool too, that I don't know how many other people might have mentioned that truck to him, or had something to do with that truck towards him, or you know, with him. But I showed him, you know, whenever I got there, I shook his hand, introduced myself, and he signed in the paper, and I said, you wouldn't happen to be able to sign this too, would you? And he said, yeah, sure. And and I'm tell you what, if y'all don't know Chip Foose, he is a cool guy. He is awesome. And you know, it's just a long storyline behind him too. But anyway, so I asked him if he would be able to sign that truck, and he said, yeah, I'll sign it. And as soon as he got ready to sign, he said, you know, this truck about made it here today. And I was like, man, that would have been awesome. I'm a big fan of it, you know, just because of the storyline behind the truck. So, you know, it's kind of got like a special place. I mean, that's about all I can say, you know. It's kind of, I guess, a bond as far as him and his dad in that truck, and then me and my dad in my dad's truck. So it's just kind of something that, and this is something that's been over time thing. It's not something, you know, it's been a long time like that. But that's just something that kind of, I guess, made me kind of look up the Chip, you know. You know, if y'all have any kind of big idols or famous people that y'all would like to meet, leave them down in the comments. Let me know who y'all would like to meet, who y'all would like to get an autograph from and shake hands with, you know. I'm gonna tell you what, you know, it's still sinking in that I just got to meet Chip Foose, you know? Somebody that I've seen on TV for years. And just because he lives over in California, you know, to me personally, I would never be able to get over to California to meet him. Or if I did, who knows when that would be. So I'm sorry, I'm still trying to let this all sink in, but describe it in words to, you know, it's just, I'm still letting it sink in. Better than that.